Alchemy, the art of equivalent exchange. You get something by giving something. Except you can't get dead people back. Like, that's the one rule entertainment industries all across the world follow. You can't bring dead people back to life, even if you have fucking magic dragons in your story. But these two brothers, Edward and Alphonse, tried to bring their dead mother back anyways. But they realize that life is unfair. Ed loses his limbs and Alphonse loses, well, his entire fucking body in exchange for something that turns atheist people religious. And talking about unfair, you know what else would be unfair? You not subscribing and pressing the bell notifications. So subscribe and press the bell notifications. I know that was bad, man. But anyways, Ed gets an automail as a replacement for his lost limbs. Alphonse gets his soul attached to the cutest looking armor in all of fiction, and thus begins their journey to fix the horrors of their childhood. By the way, this is a military anime, so most of the characters are in the military. Introducing the king of the place where most of the story takes place, King Bradley. Everyone and their moms favorite character, Roy Mustang, best girl Risa Hawkeye, Wholesome Hughes, and some side characters. Mustang sends Ed and Al to meet this alchemist in order to find some info to fix the horrors of their childhood. But some more horror happens, which turns religious people atheist. And hey, I forgot to introduce the other protagonist of the story, Scar. This dude is angry at colonization, so he keeps blasting people's faces until he becomes an ally to the main protagonist later in the story. So anyways, Hughes discovers that the government might be evil, but before he can tell anyone, he gets killed by the government, by lust. And from that day, whenever a tragedy happens in the otaku community, you are just supposed to say,
"It's a terrible day for rain."
And everyone will believe that you are a filthy fucking weeb. Ed and Alphonse are still on their conquest to fix the horror.
Full Metal Alchemist. Full Metal Alchemist.
They want to find things about this magic stone called Philosopher's Stone that might fix everything. So they meet their sensei Izumi, and at this point the author is just flexing her ability to create good f***ing shonen female characters. But anyways, we meet the final villain Father and the sub-villains Seven Deadly Sins. King Bradley is also one of the sins, by the way, so yeah, the government is indeed evil. But of course, Greed, one of the Seven Deadly Sins, is the coolest of them all. But Father boils him alive. But don't worry, another cool-ass character is introduced, Ling. And he wants to become a king using the Philosopher's Stone, so he becomes an ally of the good people. Meanwhile, Mustang is doing some investigations on Hugh's death, and he comes face to face with Lust. Now, Lust is hot, but Mustang is hotter, so Lust is dead. The good guys kidnap Gluttony and kind of come to conclusion that Bradley's a villain, but when Gluttony finds out that Mustang fried Lust, he gets angry, and through the power of friendship, he eats Ed, Ling, and Envy. These three guys form a temporary alliance inside Gluttony's body and eventually get out of Gluttony. They come face to face with Father, and he takes two cool-ass characters, combines them to form a super-duper cool-ass character. Mustang got some competition now. New character war criminal Kimberly is introduced, and he's basically an ally of the bad people. Now we get to have some world building in the story by having Ed and Al visit North. Olivia is introduced, and she basically makes people wish they were Gluttony. Sloth is in the North too, and man, if I were to fight one of the sins, I'm definitely choosing Sloth, cause this motherfucker slow as hell. Wait, never mind. Bradley's son is revealed to be Pride, and he's indeed very intimidating. But well, he can't win against the protagonist's overpowered dad. Cut the kid some slack. Or don't. because he killed his ally Gluttony. And that's like the other rule you don't break, no matter how evil you are. You don't kill your allies. That's very bad. We are getting into the final arc, if this show even has arcs, like it's only 60 episodes or something. The point is, we are heading towards the conclusion. Mustang proves why he's everyone and their mom's favorite character. Hawkeye proves why she's the best girl. And Bradley proves that characters with katanas will always be cool as hell. And I'm sorry, I've completely f***ed the chronological story order at this point. But hopefully, people watching this video aren't actually watching this in hope of getting FMAB explained. Like, there are better explain videos for that, I'm sure. This is just a little nostalgia trip or something. But moving on, our other protagonist who hates colonization kills the Hitler-looking guy. Oh, how symbolic. The main villain f***ing eats God, but through the power of friendship. Through the power of brotherhood, we get the happiest ending in all of fiction, and I'm so glad to say this since my last video was on Hunter x Hunter, and we all know the ending of Hunter x Hunter is. Forget about Hunter x Hunter, this video is on FMAB. And what an ending that was. Totally deserving of the top 1 spot on my anime list. I don't care what anyone else says, and neither should you. Bye.